It was around 1,000 years ago, in the middle of the prime time of the Vikings. Back then, some of the most important Norse gods had a dispute. They were arguing about the future, the destiny of the Vikings. And as none of them could convince their counterparts, they decided to make a bet out of it. They gave the Vikings 100 years to reach beyond their world, to send a message to Valhalla, to show that they were more than just brave warriors. And so, the great race to Valhalla began. Many tried, but bound to their human bodies, none of the brave Vikings were even able to come close to Valhalla. After many years of trying and countless failed attempts, most deemed the task impossible, and the task of the gods was slowly forgotten. Not for everyone, though. There was a boy at the mere age of 10 years. He had heard about the impossible task, and while he was not the fastest, and by far not the strongest Viking, he was one of the smartest. He knew that the task given to them was impossible for a human to handle, so he decided to not handle the task as a human. He needed someone much smaller, much faster, someone who would be able to cross the ocean and overcome the highest mountains, someone who could pass by the forgotten lands and overcome environments that were even for the Vikings too harsh to live in. He started to train a little bird, and while the other Vikings were busy fighting each other and conquering other countries, he spends all of his time preparing his little friend for the big adventure that lay ahead of them, an adventure that should decide the fate of all Vikings. As the boy turned 14, he decided that it was time to say goodbye to his friend. He had taught the bird everything it needed to know, everything he knew, everything that might be important on its journey. He had taught the bird how to survive, how to find his way even under the worst conditions, and most importantly, he had taught the bird the utmost importance of its task. From legends, the boy knew the path that was supposed to lead to Valhalla. The little bird had to pass by the old village near the water. It had to climb up the forgotten ice path to finally reach the frozen mountain lake. From there, it had to find the old mines, which should eventually lead to the long-forgotten volcano fortress. He didn't know where to go from there, but he was sure his little friend would figure it out once it reached the top of the volcano.
Thank you.
The little bird knew of the importance of its task and didn't want to lose any time. It started flying, and before it even knew, it had already passed by the old village near the water and was straight on its way to the forgotten ice path. The forgotten ice path was a place unlike anything the bird had ever seen before. It was beautiful yet scary, as even time itself seemed to have frozen at this place. It was so cold here, but the sun shining over the tops of the mountains warmed the feathers of the little bird. The little bird knew it could not rest here and continued on its journey without a second thought. After a while, the ice path came to an end and opened up to a huge lake. This must be the frozen lake, the bird thought to itself, and started to search for clues that could lead to the old mines. It took a while, but after exploring the whole area, the little bird eventually found the clue that it was looking for. It was a tiny cave that had led to the entrance of the old mine. The old mine itself was a truly confusing place. It looked like people would still be working here, while in reality, everyone had already left a long time ago. There was a huge area above the ground, but an even bigger one beneath it. And while the little bird was afraid of the narrow caves and mine shafts, it did not spare a moment to rest, but continued to look for the entrance of the long-forgotten volcano fortress. Somewhere deep beneath the ground. After a relentless search, the little bird finally made it to the volcano fortress. Now, there was only one task left to do, only one more thing to do. The little bird wanted to spread its wings and search for clues on how to enter Valhalla, but it was too tired. It had not taken a break for weeks, and therefore, it had run out of energy. Worn out by exhaustion, the little bird fell to the ground and closed its eyes one last time. It was like a dream. The little bird didn't feel his weight anymore, and the exhaustion of the last weeks had simply disappeared. It could hear the gods whisper somewhere in the back of its head, but it could not understand what they said until one of the voices rose out of the noise. It was loud and clear, and it spoke directly to the little bird. "Your passion is remarkable. Your will to come here unseen. You are small. Yet your brave heart seems to be too big to fit in this small body. We have heard your message loud and clear. Your task is now complete, little bird."